بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My name is Shafizan Bima Manasi. My ID student number 20214951. So today I would like to present two pests. And the first pest I want to present is Astronia furnacalis. So this is Astronia furnacalis. Common name Asia cornbark, and the scientific name Astronia furnacalis. So let's see about the life cycle of Astronia furnacalis. It a legging group at the base and underside of leaf. They hatch after 3 to 5 days and larva in the waist of leaves. But as they grow, they move to the tassels, mayflower, and they into the ears, feeding on the sieve, femiflower, and cranes. The late stage bore into the stuff to feed. After 15 to 22 days of feeding, the larva form propia pupa, reaching the stem. This stage lasts 7 to 15 days before the mother emerges. The female's mouth lay up to 1500 eggs, and the female is pale yellow and male is dark. So, let's see about the damaging symptom. The pest attack all stiff of the growth of the maize plant, which they attack almost all part of the plant. The symptom of the attack can be seen on the leaf, stem, flower, and also cup. They bore hole into the stem and cup and feed on the seed as we ask the kernels. The mature larva commonly feed on the stalk. The rest is seen around the hole. The larva may reach above the entry hole. In control management, IPN control, integrate control to control this pest require appreciate integration because the attack fluctuates from time to time. The cultural control is remove the tassels from 75% of plant, which is cutting some male flower that is 4 round or 6 round. For the chemical control, insecticides have shown some effective for the control. However, many disadvantages of this method of control are recognized such as necessity of frequency, high cost and application of chemical. So let's see the second pest. The common name, whiteback plant tuber, and the scientific name, Sugatella fulcifera. Let's see the taxonomy of the Sugatella fulcifera. Its to live needs 6 to 7 days, and need to adopt needs 13 to 16 days. And this is the life cycle of the Sugatella fulcifera. This is the identification of insect pests in the 3 categories, egg, neem, and adult. So you can see, this is the key category of the identification of insect pests. So what's symptom of damage? Symptom of damage such the sap and tail stunts grow. Upper bun is caused in irregular patch. Every position, every functional mark exposing the plant to fungal and bacterial infection. Red start or grassy start virus disease bun may be observed. Detection and inspection. Look for light brown plant tuber with a distinctive white line in the center of the triangular shield that cover part of the head and thorax. Look for plants that have sooty mouths at the base of the plant and other that have wilt, rave out and collapse due to happen bun. In the control management of the Sugatella fulcifera, have 3 solutions. Firstly, cultural control. Before planting, aim to plant neighboring fern within 3 weeks of each other to avoid overlapping crop and movement of the plant tuber between fields. During growth, monitor with light bulbs over pump of water away from nursery and outside of field. Apply nitrogen in split dose, being careful not to accept local recommendation. Grow only 2 crops per year and use early maturing variants. Drain field for 3 or 4 days if heavy infestation occurs. After harvest, do not rotate the crop. Do not allow it to regrow once. Continue growing after harvest. Plant the field after harvest, removing the tubers that would otherwise allow the plant tuber to continue to breed. Second natural enemy, the whiteback plant tuber is usually controlled the myriad bug, Citrophrenus leafy D. penis. However, the balance can be disturbed if broad spectrum insecticides are used to control the plant tuber or other pests. Lastly, chemical control. Recommendation of IRI is to only use pesticide in the nursery if more than 1 plant tuber per stand and more plant tuber than natural enemy. If using an insecticide, avoid the consecutive use of the same produce. If the insect are present, do not use broad spectrum product, especially early in the season. Try to use those that are more specific for the pest that you are trying to manage. Consider the effect of insecticide on parasitoid and predator, especially early in the season. Resurgent is a common problem after application of broad spectrum insecticide as they destroy natural enemies. When using a pesticide, always wear protective clothing and follow the instruction of the product label, such as the safe timing of application and pre-harvest interval.